We have it just in a tank of water. It's facing upward. This is a real human kidney stone in this channel right here. And the idea of being in the setup is first we can use our Doppler ultrasound to locate the stone.
So you can see it.
Yeah, so it shows up as this twinkling pattern. Once you have actually located the stone, and you target on the stone or just behind the stone, and then press a foot pedal or press the button, and
you can see it moving.
The stone will actually go up.
So you're actually moving the kidney stone inside somebody's body without actually having to do surgery on it.
Exactly, completely non-invasive.
That's amazing. So obviously, we were talking about if an astronaut or a cosmonaut had this up in orbit, you can't really just start doing surgery up here, so you guys can use this.
Right, exactly. You could basically target the stone, identify the path for it to move out of where it's stuck into the ureter, and just push it right along until it exits right outside the kidney.
NASA's very interested in it because it's going to survive in space.
Yeah.
It's a software-based device, so you can send upgrades up to space without flying new hardware.
Yeah, to swap it out, right.
And then we have these new capabilities. It's not just a standard ultrasound imager. It's able to move stones.
Yeah.
Or other researchers in this group are looking at treating bone loss with ultrasound.
Right.
So we can feed those in, maybe with a new probe, maybe with a software upgrade, but you don't have to change that hardware that is radiation hardened.
Yeah, so I think you hit up on a point I think a lot of people don't realize, that you can't just fly a normal piece of equipment up to the space station. That radiation is an issue up there, especially if you start talking about going to Mars. So the equipment's got to be built for that specific purpose to adapt to that environment.
The ultrasound that they've flown on station is in low Earth orbit. It doesn't see the same radiation load that a machine would see once we leave on a long duration mission.
You talk about just normal things that happen to us here on Earth that you get 6-7 months out into space that could be a big deal. Something that's kind of a routine, something you could just go to the doctor for. You have a doctor up there.
Exactly right. I think there is also an earthbound application here, that most people that come in have small stones, and the doctors say drink a ton of water and try to get those to pass naturally.
Yeah.
And they don't always. And then they have to have a surgery that's got some complications. So we would help those small stones pass. Come right in, maybe even save the patient x-ray CT to find the stone, because the urologist could write in his or her office and see it. And they're not so great at seeing it on ultrasound maybe right now, but if you could say, I think that's a stone, let's nudge it. Oh yeah, it's a stone, it's moving.
Yeah.
And then not only see it, but encourage that to leave right there and then. In fact, they might be in the doctor's office. There could be some discomfort in passing stones, but you know when it's going to happen. So then the doctor could already prepare the patient, give some analgesics, give a dilator that helps the stone pass through the ureter. And it's all timed within a very narrow window where they're in supervised care.
Yeah.
As opposed to, it could be weeks when they tell them to go home and drink, and at some point it's going to start to pass, or it won't.